Do subscribe to Ekeeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello friends, today we are starting a new subject named as Structural Analysis 1, subtopic three-hinged arches. In three-hinged arches, there are three types of problems comes in exam. First one is supported at same level, second one is supported at different level, and third one is circular arch. Today we are seeing supported at same level. Let's see. Three-hinged arches type on supported at same level. In supported at same level, first we have to see what is arches. What is look like arches? Your arches is look like this. And the name indicates it's a three-hinged arches. This is number one hinge, this is number two hinge, and this is number three hinge. And this one is your L stands for span, and this is your H is nothing but rise of the arches. And this is your tension sign. This one is your compression sign. Tension means two arrows are kissing each other is nothing but tension. Or two arrows are away from each other is nothing but compression. In this chapter, only comes compression because of three-hinged arches, and in this problems you have to come three types of load in exam. So let's see what are the three types of load. This is your VA, this is your HA, this is your VB, this is HB, this is nothing but ground. One load is UVL, other load is UDL, and the third one is point load. The first load is point load, second one is UDL, and third one is UVL. These types of loads comes in exam. And you have in type 1, you have to remember one formula. This name as y is equal to 4h upon l square into lx minus x square. This is your main formula of this chapter. You have to remember this formula, y is equal to 4h upon l square into lx minus x square. And in this chapter, H is always inward. Why H is always inward? As you are seeing, this HA and HB are always inward. Why this is always inward? Because load are coming from upward. This, for example, this is your arch, load is coming from upward. Your arch is trying to spread like this. Like this, you have to spread. For you to resist this, you have to apply H at same direction. That's why in this chapter, H is always inward. Now we are starting one problem, type 1. This types of problem comes in exam for question number 1, 5 marks. A 3-hinged arches of span 40 meter and rise 8 meter carries a concentrated load of 200 kN and 150 kN at a distance of 8 meter and 16 meter from the left hand end. And an UDL of 50 kN per meter on the right half of the span, find the horizontal thrust. Now I am explaining you what is horizontal thrust. First we have to draw the diagram. This is your solution. This is your diagram. See, a 3-hinged arch of span 40 meter and rise 8 meter. This is your span 40 meter and rise 8 meter. Concentrated load of 200 kN and 150 kN at a distance of 8 meter and 16 meter from the left end. This is your 200 kN from 8 meter, 150 from 16 meter from left side. And a UDL of 50 kN on the right half of the span, and a 50 kN is on the right half of the span. Now you have to calculate horizontal thrust. Is nothing but you have to calculate this VA value, this HV value, and this HA, and this HB. We have to calculate H this problem. Now first we have to calculate support reaction calculation. In support reaction calculation, we are calculating first summation moment, then second one summation Fy, then third one summation Fx. First we have to calculate the moment. Taking moment at A is equal to 0, that sign conversion is clockwise positive. In clockwise positive, as you can see in beams, is also like a arch, is also a arch. In beams, first we have to see, we have to take one rod and fix it from A as you are taking moment at A, and take downward of 200 kN and try to bend like this downward. So 200 into the distance. 200 into the distance is 6 meter. 6 meter. As you all know, what is moment? Moment is nothing but force into that perpendicular distance. And the second one is 150 into 16. This is also clockwise, like this. 150 plus 6 meter plus 150 into 16. As you all know, this is your 150 into the distance, force into that perpendicular distance. Now it's come UDL. As you all know how to convert point load into UDL. Sorry, UDL into point load. That is 50, this 50 into plus 50 into 20 is nothing but it's your load, not distance. And your distance will be 50 divided by 2 plus this 20. Distance will be into 30. This is your distance minus this. You are fixed like this and your VB will be unknown. Minus VB into the distance 40. Minus VB into 40 is equal to 0. While solving this, we get the value of VB is equal to 850 kN. After that, you have to apply summation Fy is equal to 0 upward positive. See, your VB will be 850 kN, and upward positive nothing but VA minus plus 120, sorry, VA plus minus 200 minus 150 minus 50 into 20 plus 850 is equal to 0. VA minus 200 minus 150 minus 50 into 20 plus 850 is equal to 0. While solving this, you get the value of VA will be 500 kN. Your VA will be 500 kN. Now you have to solve third part. Third part is nothing but horizontal thing but H. Taking bending moment at C is equal to 0. This is a sign conversion of bending moment. As you all know, there are huge difference between moment and bending moment. This is nothing but moment, bending moment. And after that, we are seeing this is moment and this is bending moment. And what is bending moment? We are taking bending moment from center. Either we have to take the section from left or right. So we are taking the section from left. Now we are taking bending moment at C. There is huge difference between moment and bending moment. What is moment? Moment is nothing but force into perpendicular distance. Bending moment is also nothing but force into perpendicular distance. But in bending moment, we are taking bending moment from, we are taking bending moment from A. We have to consider part either left or right. For example, we are taking bending moment at C. We have to consider either part CA or part CB. We are consider part CA like this, and you have to follow this sign conversion. This from the left upward positive, downward negative. Follow this sign conversion for bending moment. Sagging or hogging. This is sagging, this is hogging. Now we have to take this bending moment at C, for example, this. We are taking bending moment from C, your beam will like to bend like this. For example, this like this. Your 500 will be this distance. Then your 500 plus this sign conversion follow 500 into the distance is, nothing but 20. 500 into 20. Now this one, this is coming like this. This follow the 200 is follows this sign conversion. This is nothing but minus 200, this distance, force into perpendicular distance, 200 into this distance, then 200 into 12, then minus 150 into this 4, 150 into 4, minus, now this H is also coming. Now H is nothing but 4, your this perpendicular distance will be 8, but this will be minus or plus, this will be minus, because if you open your arch, your edge will be like this. Your edge will be like this. This is nothing but this sign conversion follows this one. This is nothing minus edge into your perpendicular distance will be 8 is equal to 0. While solving this, you get the value of edge is nothing but 875 kilonewton. As you all know, in this chapter, both the edge are same. HA is equal to HB is equal to 875 kilonewton. H is always inward, their H value will be always inward. This H will be 875 kilonewton. This H will be 875 kilonewton. And this is your final answer of horizontal thrust. H is equal to 875 kilonewton. Thank you friends for watching this video. I hope you can understand this topic. They may support it at same level. So subscribe this Ekeeda channel and share this video with your friends. Thank you.